Do you have a YouTube channel for your farm? If not, you should. Now, once you have YouTube videos that you're posting on your farm's page, where are you putting the link? How do you get the word out? How do you publicize that they exist so people can find them? That's what I'm going to talk about in this training. Hi, I'm Corinna Bench, and I am the founder of mydigitalfarmer.com, which is all about helping farmers get more confident at digital marketing. I'm also the founder and owner of Shared Legacy Farms. We have been doing an organic vegetable CSA since 2008, and I have been doing digital marketing for the last 2.5 years and having some crazy results, and I love sharing those tips with my farmer friends. If you would like to get inside my private Facebook group where I do a weekly deep dive training, you can go to sharedlegacyfarms.com/DF Lab for Digital Farmer Lab, and you will subscribe and you will be sent the link to that group. So, where do you put YouTube video links? Now, if you just watched my training that was all about how do you even create content, what kind of content would you create for YouTube to help with the sales push for a CSA, to help people move down the sales journey, then I kind of left it off at the end saying, well, here are some great videos, but how do you help people find them? How do you get people to discover the playlist, the first video or the second video in your playlist that will guide them down the sales journey? So here are some ideas. There are lots of places that you could be posting these videos once you make them. For instance, you could embed the first video in your playlist sequence on your website. So pick the top video or the one that you want them to see most. Maybe it's the one that's about a frequently asked question and you know it's going to pull them in. Or maybe it's the one about, is CSA right for you? And that's really where you want the first question you want them to ask. Put that video on your homepage of your website or on the pricing page or the main sales page where you're selling your CSA. Embed it. Put the link in there. And once they click on it, it'll take them right to that YouTube video on your channel. And then it will tell them in the end screen, it'll say, hey, do you want to go to this next video? If you've set your cards up right, you can guide them down a journey. So that's a great place to put it on your website. You can also put one inside of a sales email. So if you are doing drip campaigns like I coach my students to do, then you can have specific videos inside of these individual emails that are part of the larger campaign. If you want to answer a particular question that you know people have in order to get them to want to buy and finally, click on the buy now link in your email, maybe they need to see a video to answer it. So rather than spend a whole ton of paragraphs in this email trying to explain payment options, what if you just have a short video that walks them through it? And then in this email, they click on the link and you tell them, hey, watch this video to learn how all the payment processes work or what your payment options can be. Another idea is to put them in your weekly email. So maybe you aren't just doing a long drip campaign sales sequence, but you're showing up every week and sending an email to your list. People who have raised their hand and said, I'm interested in CSA, you've tagged them as an interested person in your CSA. You should be emailing them every week in the off season too. And so from time to time, you could put a link to one of these videos inside of that email, and it might move them along. Whenever I try to insert a video link inside of an individual email, what I usually do is create a screenshot of the actual video. So I'll play it on my computer, I'll take a screenshot, and then I'll go into canva.com, which is a free graphic design tool. I will upload that screenshot into Canva and then kind of cut and paste the picture, crop it so it looks right. And then I'll put a, like, insert a image of a playhead, like a video playhead, over the picture, and it looks like the YouTube play button on top of the picture. And then I, make it look right and make it look pretty, and then I download that as a PNG file. That goes onto my computer, and then that goes into my email as the photo. So when they read through the email, they see this image that looks like a play button of the video itself, and they'll want to click on the picture and watch the video. So that's a little tip that I want to share with you too. Another place that you could put your YouTube video links would be to embed them on a thank you page. So after they've purchased something else in your product, you want them to do something else, you could put a link on a thank you page. You could embed the link in the description of another YouTube video that might be in that very same playlist. So you kind of coach them through the description. Hey, this is what you want to watch. If you're interested in this topic of learning how a CSA works, I've got 3 or 4 videos that you might want to see, and you can list them and put their links. You could also embed a video link into a lead page. If you don't know what lead pages are, these are these basically like pretty looking subscribe forms. So it's a landing page that people are taken to when they want to when you want them to subscribe to a form. And so you can embed the video right on that landing page, and then they can watch the video from there. You could embed a link in a blog post if you're talking about a particular topic. Maybe it is the 5 reasons you should think about joining a CSA, and then you might embed your link for a particular video that aligns with that topic right into the blog post. And you could even put an image of that screenshot of the video in there as well to tempt them and entice them that this is something they might want to watch. Now, we haven't even touched on social yet. Obviously, social media, a very great place to be posting links to YouTube. You can upload the video itself into Facebook natively, but you can also link the YouTube video link in there as well from time to time. Hopefully you're keeping track of what those URL addresses are as you make the videos in some kind of a content log on an Excel spreadsheet, and then just scrape the URL and stick it into your social posts. You can do that every 2 or 3 weeks. Just keep repeating the same stuff. Remember, not all the same people are going through your information. And you can post it on your Instagram bio, so you can tell people in a post that, hey, go check my bio for the link to such and such video. So change out that video link from time to time based on whatever you're trying to feature, and people might go and watch the bio. You can put multiple links in your Instagram bio with a free tool called Linktree, so look that up as well. I have a whole video training all about how to use Linktree inside my group. And finally, another idea is that you could make the first video on your YouTube channel, the channel trailer, be one of these videos that you want people to watch. So you could take people to that channel trailer, and then it would lead them down this path. People will often watch the first video that's kind of featured there. So those are just a few ideas for where you can be putting these early videos and begin the trigger, right? The whole goal here is that you want to trigger the process to get them to start watching all of these videos that you've created in your playlist in the first place. So review some of these ideas, pick a few, and post some of those links to the first or second video in those locations, and it will begin a cascade of events where people will then consume and binge watch all of this video content that you've created for your sales video machine, okay? I hope this was helpful. Where are you putting your YouTube links right now? Please post that in the comments. I would love to hear if you have another suggestion that I didn't mention. And like or share this video with others so other farmers find out about this resource. Hey, you should be doing a YouTube channel. I think it's one of the top 10 marketing assets that you should build first when you're designing a digital marketing machine to get you leads and sales for your farm. If you want to know what the other 9 are, I have a list of my top 10 marketing assets that I think you should work on, and you can get that at sharedlegacyfarms.com/10things, the number 10 things. Now, if you want to get inside this private Facebook group for farmers where I do a weekly training like this one, you can go to sharedlegacyfarms.com/DFLab, as in digital farmer, DFLab. Subscribe and I'll get you in. Thanks for joining me. Check me out at mydigitalfarmer.com. You can subscribe to my YouTube channel. I would love to see you there every week. Take care.